Hi everyone, it is great to be back with you guys again. Thank you so much for hanging out here with me on a Monday. Man, I missed you guys. It feels like forever since we've been live streaming, doesn't it? I think our last one was early in September. Jerry and I did a Friday night fireside right before we took a break. So it just feels like it's been a long time. So I am so glad to be back. We had a wonderful time. We went on vacation to Maui. It was an awesome trip. It was really nice. You might have seen my Instagram post, just to unplug from everything. I don't know that I've ever done that in the 10 or 11 years we've been doing YouTube. I don't think I've ever gone for 2 weeks without being on social media at all. We did have a pre-filmed video that we posted while we were gone, but honestly, you guys, I didn't check Instagram, Facebook, or anything else, and it was actually really nice to like clear my head that way. You know, sometimes we get bogged down in everything going on with social media, and it was really refreshing just to have some time to rest, to relax, to unwind. Honestly, I was getting a little bit burnt out just with everything we had going with the book, the garden, everything over the summer. So it was really nice to get refreshed and come back just recharged, energetic, ready to hit things again, ready to be out in the garden again, ready to see you guys again and create brand new content for the fall. So super glad to be back. So hope everybody had a great couple of weeks as well. If you're brand new here, I wanna welcome you. We do live stream every Monday, except when we're taking a break. And we live stream at noon Pacific time, and we do just have so much fun sharing garden tips, support, resources, and there's just an amazing group of gardeners here in the chat. So thanks to all of you who are saying that you missed me, and good to see you. Good to see me again. It's great to see you guys too, and I'm really glad to be back on the Monday Lives. So today we're going to be talking about, first of all, happy fall. First day of fall was last week. Today is the first Monday of fall. And honestly, I think these past couple of days, it actually feels like fall here in Southern California. Today, I think it's not even 70 degrees, which is absolutely unheard of for months for here in Southern California. It's been overcast. I actually had my coat on for a little bit this morning. I know it's crazy. Southern Californians don't have a very high tolerance for cold. But then we're supposed to get back into the 90s later in the week. But happy fall to everyone. Hopefully, Max over there, I think, chasing the squirrels. Hopefully, all of you are getting some cooler weather. You might have seen the little poll I posted in the chat before the live stream. A lot of you are very excited about fall. Let's see what the numbers were. Looking down here at my computer, I asked, are you glad it's fall? I think that's still there in the chat. 64% said yes. 10% said no, and 26% said yes, but not looking forward to winter. So I think we kind of all feel the same that way. So thanks for taking my little poll and really appreciate it. So looking forward to sharing what I'm doing in the garden this week, the last week of September. And also, I want to hear from you guys what's going on in your garden as well. I posted a little poll over on Instagram on my story. So you can head over to Instagram and answer that little poll if you want to. And I'm going to be reading people's answers here on the live. So Max there wandered around behind me. He was very, very glad that we were back as well. Drew was here taking care of things and taking care of Mac. But Jerry is the alpha in the family. So Mac really missed Jerry. And he misses me too. But I think for different reasons, because I have treats in my pocket every time he comes outside with me when we're filming or taking pictures. So he always likes to get treats from my pocket. So is Marie here in the house? Oh my goodness. I want to say a special congratulations to Marie. She's been part of our community for a long time. She just had a beautiful baby girl. So Marie, congratulations. And the pictures of her are absolutely adorable. She has black hair, just absolutely gorgeous. And I think she's about a week or so old, right, Marie? So hopefully you're recovering and the baby is doing well. And she's already been posting how she's going to teach her to be a little gardener. So really excited about that. So welcome everyone. Hi Florence. Thank you so much. Great to be back as well. Hello Annie from Montreal. Great to have you here. And Lydia, no gardening this summer. And who knows why? Maybe you had some strange things or hard things going on, but hopefully you're able to get some seeds started soon. And Arlene, we're going to talk about that in just a few minutes. What should I be seeding now in zone 10B? And Flora, hello, Flora loves autumn. It's great. Nisha, hi, how are you? Nisha and Cliff, our moderators, are here. And Tina, debating a fall garden. Well, hopefully by the end of the live stream, we can convince you to get one planted. So before we start, on what I'm working on in the garden this week. I just want to draw attention to this tomato right behind me here. And Cliff is going to be especially interested in this, especially based on his posts over the weekend. Cliff grows giant vegetables. He went to an event this weekend where they had, I think a pumpkin was like 2,000 pounds. And some really big tomatoes. This is a Domingo tomato. The seeds are from Cliff. And actually, honestly, I almost pulled this plant out a couple of months ago because it wasn't doing so well. I thought, you know what, I'm going to give it another chance. I fertilized it, like added some compost, fish fertilizer, good dirt. I did everything to it. And would you believe, as we were on vacation, it absolutely took off. When I came out this morning to check on things, I couldn't believe how big this tomato is. I almost hate to touch it because I'm afraid it's going to fall off. And I'm going to have to protect it from the squirrels. I'd like it to get just a little bit riper, maybe even be able to film a video of me weighing it. But, you know, I missed the giant tomato competition, didn't do so well. But this one is coming in for possibly a late winter. So I'll be weighing that and letting you guys know how much it weighs. So that was really fun to see. Okay, so I want to start off our what I'm doing in the fall by actually reading, or what I'm doing in the garden this very last week of September before October hits, by reading a comment that was made on the Instagram video, not the Instagram video, the YouTube video that Jerry and I posted yesterday. We pulled out a garden bed of old beans and planted some peas. And I love this comment. This is from Yvonne. So I don't know if Yvonne is here in the chat today, but I absolutely love this comment. Here's what she's doing in the garden this week. And Yvonne, if you're here, let us know. She said, Kim, Jerry, great to see y'all. I had a garden party last Saturday. I made some chili and cornbread and had my entire family come out and help do a garden cleanup and fall prep. Love this. On the first day of fall, I made myself a pumpkin latte and direct sowed the pea collection. Looking forward to trying new peas this year. See you Monday for the live stream. So I just thought that was so much fun. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I get overwhelmed sometimes with all of the work there is to do in the garden. And here Yvonne, she just said, hey family, come on over, let's make a party out of it. And had a fun little fall party with chili, cornbread, garden clean out, planting fall garden, and pumpkin lattes. So I thought that was amazing. I want to encourage you guys, go for it. Get some people over to help you out, friends, family members, whatever. And just have a good time. So I love that, Yvonne, and I hope you're here today to hear that I loved your comment. Okay, so I'm gonna jump into the first thing that I've been doing, actually, since we've been back from vacation, and what I'm gonna be continuing to do this week. And what I'm doing, you guys, is I'm taking a little chunk of time each day, because basically my whole garden turned into a jungle. When you're not in the garden for 2 weeks, there's a lot of things that happen. And hopefully you saw my video that I did, kind of a walk around, the first time in the garden for 2 weeks since we've been gone. And you'll see how much growth we had. And Les Robot 01, thank you so much. A $4.99 super chat, really appreciate it. What a great way to show your support. Thank you so much. And Les's comment is, picked a large box of tomatoes and another of various pepper varieties yesterday before today's steady rain in Western Oregon. That is amazing. It's so great to bring in those last harvests of the season, and especially before you're stuck in the house with rain. So thank you so much, Les. Appreciate your support. And it's really exciting that you're able to have such a great harvest. And yes, Cliff, I'm sorry if I didn't mention that. That's called Domingo. And I think that Cliff has some pictures on his Instagram of some giant Domingos. So maybe a few of you, maybe Cliff included, could give me an idea of how much you think this giant will weigh. So put your guesses here down in the chat, because I'd be interested to see if anyone guesses correctly. So as I was saying, the garden was a jungle. So number one thing that I'm doing this week, and I've already started on Sunday, or actually Friday, I was able to get in here and start on this, is decide what to pull and what to keep. There's tons of stuff that needs to come out. And as I mentioned on our video from yesterday, what I look for is the appearance of the plant, number one. And if you saw our video, you saw that those scarlet runner beans, which honestly didn't look too bad a couple of weeks ago, really took a dive while we were gone. We did have some heat and they just browned almost completely, and they got completely infested with aphids. So Jerry was a little bit freaked out by that. I'm kind of used to seeing aphids in the garden. And they don't bother me at all, but he's not at all used to it. So he was a little bit like, ooh, I got aphids all over me now. So I look at the appearance of the plant, and it looked terrible. If you saw that video, that was one clue to pull it out. The second thing I always look for is it still producing? And that one was really overgrown and had lots of large pods on it. It really wasn't producing any new growth or anything new like that. So that's another clue that it was ready to come out. And the third one, which I already mentioned, was pests and diseases. And as you saw, it was clearly infested with aphids. There were tons of ants, but the main thing was the aphids. So all three things, and that plant had to come out, and we were able to plant some brand new fall crops in its place. So that's the first thing I am doing this week, is deciding what to pull and what to keep. Now we're gonna head back into the chat, and I wanna hear from you guys. What are you pulling out in your garden right now? What are you keeping? You know, the seasons are changing, and your tomatoes, your warm weather crops might be coming to an end. It's a great time to start planting those cool weather vegetables, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. And I see a lot of comments in the chat here of what your guesses are for this tomato. Let's see, I think Jackie said 2 pounds. Wow, that would be amazing. I've never grown a 2 pound tomato. V said 15.8 ounces. Okay, almost a pound from V. Amy, Jerry's reaction was hilarious. Yeah, he was pretty funny. He wasn't quite expecting that when he agreed to do that project with me yesterday. Nisha guesses 1.9 pounds. My backyard says wasps and spiders freak me out. Yeah, that can be a little bit freaky when you run across those in the garden. V said, love his reaction. Jill Goodman said 3 pounds. That would be amazing. I don't even think I know what a 3 pound tomato looks like. So I would love it if it was 3 pounds. So if you guys vote for me filming a video on harvesting this tomato this week, put your comments here in the chat. I think that would be kind of fun. It would just be a short, quick video of me picking the tomato and putting on the scale and then finding out what it really weighs. So, but I'm going to have to do it soon due to the squirrel activity we've seen going around. In fact, you might have seen on my after the vacation garden tour, I picked 3 Golden Jubilee tomatoes, and I saw a 4th one almost ripe this morning. What do you know? I come out, it's literally half eaten, and I'm sure it's why the squirrels have been running around. So that's pretty crazy. Definitely want to protect this one from that. I think Paul KV, thank you. Would love to see a video. Thank you very much. Angela guesses 14 ounces, and Cliff, the expert, guesses 1 pound, 2 ounces. So I'm going to have to make note of all these comments once the video uploads, and then when I weigh it, we'll have to see who is the closest to the actual weight itself. So stay tuned for that. Maybe I'll try and film that video either tomorrow or Wednesday. So stay tuned for that. Midweek, that should be a fun one. Okay, so let me read a couple of comments here from Instagram. I asked on my Instagram stories when I posted about the live stream, what are you doing in the garden this week? And here's a couple of responses. 808 Ladybug, who I know she's from Hawaii, she said transferring seedlings to their permanent homes, also starting another round of seeds. So that's actually a great thing to do right now, is if you started your fall garden a month ago, maybe you started your seeds inside in little seed cells or whatever, now's a great time to transplant them, either transfer them into larger containers if they're not quite ready to go outside, or start a new round. Why not have a whole new round of backup? So 808, great job. Glad you're getting out there and making your garden happen this fall. So let me just read one more before we go into the chat for questions. This is from SMC1947. This goes along right with what I said, pulling out the old plants and planting the new. And honestly, that's such a great thing to do this time of year, because you know, sometimes we all just get a little bit bogged down in the summer garden at this point in time. And like Jerry mentioned in the video yesterday, it feels really good sometimes just to clean off that trellis, get a completely brand new start. It feels fresh, it feels good, it feels new. And there's just something about starting over and then seeing the brand new plants come up out of the soil. So great job on that as well. And I'll read a couple more in just a little bit in the live stream. But for now, let's head into the chat, see what you all are doing in the garden before I share another thing that I'm doing this week. Terry is guessing 1 pound and 2 ounces on the tomato. Okay, good guess, Terry, because that's what Cliff guessed as well. So he's usually in the know about that. And here's a comment from Sharon from Virginia. I finally got most of my fall garden seedlings in the garden. Way to go. I covered them with tulle to protect them from pests. I harvested and pulled the corn and some flowers. Okay, it's always good to get out there. Always feels good to get your hands in the soil. And get, especially when you have to do some protection from the critters, kind of check on things and just kind of get a pulse on how the garden is doing. So I bet that was a really good day out there, Sharon. Way to go. Okay, let's see here. Chanel. Hi, Chanel. How are you doing? Started collard, spinach, broccoli, cauliflower, lettuce, and kale. All amazing cool weather vegetables. Always feels so good to get those new seedlings started and to know that you're going to have fresh new variety in the garden very soon. Okay, I'm going to share, let's see, the next thing I'm doing this week. And as you could tell from the video we posted yesterday, is I have some issues with this right now. And that is prune. I just mentioned pruning. That is spraying. Some pests came in while we were gone. You know, while I'm away, they're going to play and have a good time without anyone checking on them. And as you saw in my garden tour video, we did have some hornworm damage, some huge hornworms that just pretty much munched through some of my eggplant, really stripped some tomatoes pretty badly. Thankfully, they did not get to this one right here. And then tons of aphids. So that's one thing I'm doing this week is I'm going to be going around pruning, pulling things out, like I mentioned in my first item, and then also pruning. There's a lot of things I don't have to pull out that I can prune back, such as, I don't know if you can see in these leaves here, but I've got some tomatoes right up here as well. In fact, most of my tomatoes have a lot of yellowing leaves and branches on them. So that's one big thing I'll be doing this week is pruning all those yellowing leaves out. Now, some of the tomatoes might need to be taken out. We'll see how that goes. It really just depends on how they look, you know, once I get in there and take an assessment of them. But some I can just prune and then spray for like spider mites and aphids. And one thing I did forget to mention in the video yesterday is that all the aphids that I sprayed off of the trellis, I said I'm spraying these so they don't fall down on the garden bed. Well, someone said, well, they are falling on the garden bed because you're spraying them. And actually what I meant to say was I'm spraying them so they fall down now, but they don't fall down on the brand new plants as they emerge out of the soil. So what I am going to be doing, though, is spraying the soil with neem oil to take care of the aphids before the peas start to grow, and then spraying off aphids from plants around the garden as well as other pests. So I've been spraying with the Bonaid neem oil, and this has worked really, really well for me this year. And this actually is a concentrate, but I've been putting it in one of those, not the hose and sprayers, but the pump sprayers. So it works really good. You don't have to mix up a ton at once. I just spray a little bit each day and then, you know, mix it up again the next day. And I usually try and use everything I mix in one day. And it's actually been working really well against the aphids and also against the powdery mildew. I was pleasantly surprised at how well it really controls the powdery mildew. So if you haven't grabbed some of this neem oil, there'll be a link in the video description. This is by Bonaid, and I've been working with them as one of my brand partners this year, and their products are really good, and they also work fairly quickly. They have tons of products for organic gardening. So that's one thing I really like about their products as well. So let me see if I wanted to mention anything else on that. So we've mainly had the aphids, the ants, and the hornworms. That's what I'm going to be taking care of this week and trying to do a little bit on that each day so I don't get too terribly overwhelmed. Okay, back in the chat here. Let's see what else you guys are doing this week and what questions you have, either about pulling plants out, pruning, spraying, or anything else that should be done in the last week of fall here. Okay, Lydia says, I use that in my garden and I love it. Okay, great. I'm so glad to hear that, Lydia. Really appreciate that. I'll send that feedback on to Bonaid as well. And they always love to hear that their products are working. Luz, how are you doing, Luz? Great to see you today. I'm in the process of slowly amending my beds to get my seedlings transplanted. Spinach, broccoli, kohlrabi, Brussels sprouts, and onions. Wow, you've got some great crops growing there, Liz. Way to go. And I like what you said about slowly amending. And I think that's one thing that I myself kind of struggle with sometimes. I don't know about you guys, but feeling like I have to get everything done in one day. So I don't know why I put that pressure on myself. But that's one thing I actually thought a lot about while I was gone. And hold that thought, because we have a super chat here from Jill. $5. Jill, you're so kind. Thank you so much. I saved my garden from aphids and spider mites thanks to you and Gary. Great, that's awesome. Started my indoor garden to get away from the bugs. Now I have soil gnats. Oh my gosh, that's crazy, Jill. Those can be really, really pesky inside the house. And you can actually use this neem spray indoors as well. So you may want to try that on your plants. And you can also put little bottle caps of apple cider vinegar with a few drops of dish soap around your house, and that will help around your plants inside, and that will help a lot with the fungus gnats as well. So great. Thank you so much, Jill. I really appreciate your super chat. So as I was saying, one thing I thought about a lot while we were gone and while we were on break is just not putting so much pressure on myself, because I work a lot of hours, usually sometimes around 12 hours a day, pretty much on a regular basis. And sometimes it's because I need to, because I have projects or videos I'm filming for companies or for our YouTube channel or the book, but sometimes it's due to pressure I put on myself. So one thing I'm really working on is finding a healthier balance there, shutting the office door a little bit earlier, and doing things I really enjoy, being out in the garden more, spending more time with my family, and just really giving myself smaller goals. So I like that you said you're doing a little bit each day, Luz. I think that's very wise and really helps develop those healthy patterns in your life. So I am right there with you. So thanks a lot for sharing that. Really appreciate it. Okay, question here from Terry. How's it going, Terry? Great to see you here. And her question, Terry's question is, my mini watermelons are growing bigger, but the leaves started to get dry. Should I just keep feeding? Should I just prune the dead leaves? I'd say, Terry, it really depends on the weather. If you are coming up to like a frost or anything like that, if your days are getting shorter and you're not getting a lot of warmer weather, I would, you know, if you're definitely, if you're getting a frost, you need to pick the watermelon. A sign though of watermelon being ripe is a dry, the tendril that's closest to the melon itself on the vine, the little tendril is drying up. So if that little tendril is drying up, that's a sign that your watermelon is ripe. Otherwise, if you still have some hot weather left, some warm weather left, I would go ahead and trim up those dry leaves and give it a dose of maybe a low, not a super high nitrogen fertilizer, but maybe just like the worm cat, the worm vermistera worm tea, just to keep it fed and keep that slow and steady growth going. And you may be able to size up your watermelon just a little bit more. So that's a really good question. Thanks a lot for asking. Okay. Number three, what I am doing this week, and hopefully some of you are still able to do this where you live, is planting for fall. So I have been slowly planting for fall over the past couple of months. Since August, we started the fall garden series, probably mid-August. I planted some seeds, or started some seeds indoors, and have been planting some greens. We planted peas in our video on Saturday. But I want to show you guys, just in case you guys might have the misconception that everything goes perfectly in my garden. It doesn't, I'll tell you that right now. And here's what my indoor seedlings looked like when we returned. This is just one tray. Are you guys ready for this? Here you go. This was going to be my fall garden, okay? So, not looking so good, right? Things die in my garden. I did have our son Drew looking after things, and these did get watered, but they're looking pretty bad. And they were just, honestly, before we left, we were gone for almost two weeks, and they were ready to get planted when we left, and it was way too hot. I didn't have time to plant them, and they would have died outside in the heat anyway. So I was kind of, you know, preparing myself for the reality that they were not going to make it. So in case you feel like you're the only ones that plants die, I'm here to tell you I've been gardening for probably 15 years or so, and this is what happened to three trays of my plants while we were gone. So needless to say, what I'm doing this week is starting brand new seeds for fall. And it's actually, the timing works out really well. Thank you so much, Terry, and happy birthday today. That's awesome. Birthday lunch after your podcast, so I wouldn't miss it. That's great, after the live stream. Wonderful, Terry. Thank you so much. Happy birthday, and have a great, wonderful, special day. So anyway, I'm starting new fall seeds this week, which actually ends up being really good timing because in California and southern climates, our best time to grow cooler vegetables are the months of November, December, through probably the end of February. So if I would have started and planted everything outdoors in September, it's just too hot. So starting new seeds indoors about 6 weeks, which takes me to about the middle of November, they'll be going outside and then growing throughout the winter months. So if you live in a southern climate, get your fall seeds started. It's not too late. You'll definitely want to grab the fall garden seed collection. And as we mentioned on Saturday, the pea seed collection, which I actually just came out with kind of in the winter last year, I believe, is a good one to grab as well. So the fall garden has 13 varieties. It has things like collards, spinach, radishes, carrots. It's packed full of 13, 14 varieties. Mustard greens. Oh, nasturtiums are one of my favorite flowers, which I actually have some already coming up. Cabbage, beets, mustard greens, all kinds of fun things. So you can grab one of these. And the sale for the week is, what do you guys think? Happy fall, 20% off. So it's the first sale I've run, I think, for about 3 weeks since we've been gone. So happy fall, 20% off. Whoops. We'll grab you one of these over at CallieKimGardeningHome.com. Last day is today. You got to plant peas too, you guys. Peas are a winner for just about everybody. They're frost tolerant. They'll take light frost, not real heavy frost. But southern climate gardeners, about 8 to 10 weeks to harvest. Northern climate gardeners, you might be a little bit on the late side for the peas. But we're going to talk about something that you can do during the cold winter months in just a moment. So definitely not too late to get those cool weather vegetables growing for us southern gardeners. They like cooler temperatures, 75 to 80 or below. So we're coming into that time, the real sweet spot. It's a really pleasant time to garden in the fall for like people in Florida, Texas, myself, because it's just not as, you know, hot and crazy in the fall. So definitely don't give up on that garden just yet. Now, one of the questions I get asked probably the most is it too late to plant? Or what can I plant now in zone 10 or zone whatever? And I want to encourage you guys, if you have any, I know a lot of you guys have my book, but because I've gotten so many questions lately, I would encourage you to pick a copy of my book up and get it with that 20% Happy Fall discount. Because in my book, I teach basic gardening principles of cool weather vegetables, warm weather vegetables, how to start from seed, how to get grow lights set up, how to get things planted in the garden, how to set up drip irrigation, all the basics that you need to know to make homegrown vegetables easy. So grab this, it's a great garden resource. And get ready, you guys, because my book on raised bed gardening is coming out, hopefully, if there's no delays, in March. So I'm really excited about that. And you can pre-order that on Amazon. All the links are on my website. Jamie, thank you so much for $4.99 super chat. We started seeds from the fall seed collection that you sent along with the smart pots after the Friday fireside chat. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad that you received that. She was one of the winners on our Friday fireside chat of a giveaway that camera guy did spontaneously. So you never know when that's going to happen. But I'm super happy for you. And thank you so much for the super chat. Really appreciate it. Okay, let me grab my phone here and read a couple more Instagram comments. And I do post pretty much daily on Instagram updates on what I'm doing in the garden. I always post on Mondays what the live stream's about or maybe what we did over the weekend. So do make sure you check that out, CallieKim29. And then Camera Guys is Callie Camera Guy. He always posts a lot of really cool behind the scenes pictures. So he actually posted one of me yesterday wearing a GoPro on my head. The GoPro shots didn't go so well for the video we filmed. He's practicing on that. So hopefully in the next video, we'll have some more GoPro shots. But it's pretty fun. He's got a lot of fun posts over there too. Okay, so next person who posted a response to my little Instagram poll is Nisha, who's here today on the live stream. And Nisha said she is planting garlic this weekend for the first time. So that's pretty cool, Nisha. Nisha recently moved to Colorado. You guys might have seen the video we did on that a few weeks ago. So it's a brand new climate for her. She's from Northern California. And it's going to be fun to grow garlic this winter and see how it does in a cold climate. So Nisha, you're going to have to make sure that you let us know how that goes and have a lot of fun planting it. So next person for our Instagram poll is Teeny Jeannie. Here's what she's doing this week. She's pulling up summer plants that are past their prime and planting the next wave of radishes. So Teeny Jeannie, good job on that. That's exactly what I've been doing. And I will be planting a new round of radishes right there with you. Mine didn't do so well in the heat. And I'll probably wait a couple of weeks on that until the weather gets just a little bit cooler. But those radishes are a great fall vegetable to plant as they grow so fast. They're a little bit spicy though, but really delicious in salad. So let me know how yours do there, Teeny Jeannie. And that'll be a lot of fun. And Jason saying planted my garlic as well. So great. Actually, you can plant garlic. I know Cliff has said he's going to be planting his soon. Usually a couple weeks before your frost date, or maybe a month or so before your frost date, if you have a frost date. And because garlic needs that cold winter dormant period to really take off and grow those nice big garlic bulbs during the winter time. Actually, they kind of take a little rest during the winter and then pop out once the weather gets warm in the spring. So that's a great thing to do if you're coming up on a frost date within a month or so. Okay, so next thing, let's see, that I am doing is, oh, and by the way, guys, if you want more info on fall gardening, we've got a whole playlist on fall gardening. So I've done a couple new videos in the past month on what to plant, when to plant it. We did a video on carrots, how to plant those. I'll probably be doing one in the next few weeks, how to thin carrots. We did an herb, how to plant cool weather herbs. And also the one over the weekend on how to plant peas. So lots of info and resources on our YouTube channel. And that's what we're all about here, is sharing the resources with each other. Oh, and by the way, guys, before I forget, someone mentioned Gary from The Rusted Garden. Episode number 3 of the Gardening Coast to Coast podcast drops on Friday. So I hope you guys have been enjoying that. Thank you so much for all of your support on that. It's had a very good download rate, or whatever you want to call it, people that are listening. Really appreciate it. Gary and I are having a ton of fun. The third episode drops Friday morning, and it will be on Q&A. So a lot of you sent us questions via the gardeningcoasttocoast@gmail.com email address. Also over at gardeningcoasttocoast.net, which is the website for the podcast. You can leave your question to be hopefully answered on a future podcast. So all the info is at gardeningcoasttocoast.net. And we really thank you guys for all your support. Let me know here in the chat if you've listened and how you've enjoyed the podcast, because we're having a ton of fun. We're actually recording episode number 4 on this coming Wednesday. So that will probably drop in 2 Fridays. Not sure of the date. Episode 2, I believe, came out, Cliff, maybe a week or two ago. I think it was while we were on vacation. So I think it was like the 24th or something like that. But you can get all the info over at gardeningcoasttocoast.net. Okay, Sue, let me see here. Third thing, did I miss number 2? I think I might have skipped one. No, I said decide what to pull, what to keep, prune and spray, and then plant for fall. I think I mentioned plant for fall. Yeah, start new seeds, either indoors. Yeah, that was my very sad little seed tray here. Start new seeds indoors or direct seed right in your garden. Okay, number 4. What I'm starting to do, oh, camera guy's in the house. Whoa, very cool, here he is. Okay, camera guy, back to work, back out on his lunch hour, joining us. So hi, Jerry, how's it going? Thanks for popping in. Okay, so number 4, what I'm starting to do this week is plan for my indoor garden. I feel like something's back there in the bushes. Either it's Mac or a squirrel. I'm not sure what it is, but anyway, I'm starting to plan for my indoor garden, because as the crops finish up outside and now that we're into fall, the hours of daylight are getting less. I don't get much sun in my outdoor garden, in my garden outside. Oh, it was Mac. During the winter time, pretty much just 2 to 3 hours of sunlight a day. The garden is on the north side of the house. So our house pretty much shades the garden during the winter months because the sun is lower in the sky. So I always like to plan things inside. That way I can make sure I have the things that I love to eat if they're not growing so well outdoors. So one of those things is my tiny Tim tomato, absolutely my favorite in the world, back there in the Calichim Smart Pots. And you can see how amazing this tomato is already looking. I think I started these maybe inside. Yeah, watch behind you. Thank you so much. Make sure nothing jumps out. Okay, yeah, Mac doesn't mess with the plants too much, but he does like to dig sometimes back there while I'm on the live streams. I'm not sure why, but anyway. So this was started from seed indoors about 10 weeks ago. Planted in the Smart Pots right before we left on vacation, maybe 2 weeks before that. Growing like crazy. I've got 4 or 5 of them up in front of me here on the wall. These are the best little tomatoes to grow inside during the winter time. They only grow to about 2 feet tall. They're my favorite. They are crazy productive, and I was able to grow some all the way to harvest inside under grow lights last winter. So a couple of these will definitely be brought inside, as well as, let's see, I'm going to be doing some chives inside, which here I've got some chives right here, some basil inside, probably some type of greens, some lettuce, mustard greens. Definitely microgreens are very easy to grow indoors. So for those of you that it might be a little late for to start your fall garden, if you're getting frost, like I think Cliff mentioned tomorrow, he's supposed to get frost in Idaho, or if you're in northern climates, you can't get outside in the winter time because it's just too cold, I really want to encourage you to grow an indoor garden. It is so much fun, you guys, and it really kind of scratches that gardening itch. I mean, right now, you know, you might be a little bit burnt out, but believe me, once it gets cold, you're gonna wish that you had something green growing. You're gonna wish that you had some plants inside, some fresh vegetables. It's easy to grow a little salad garden. And we're gonna be doing a whole indoor garden series starting maybe in October at some point. But in the meantime, go back and watch last year's indoor garden series. There's lots of videos on that. And I do have a special seed collection that I designed particularly for indoor growing. You really want to keep it easy when it comes to your indoor garden. I myself would have a really hard time growing full-size tomatoes. I just don't have the space. I don't have the grow light set up, enough grow lights to do that. But the smaller size vegetables, like the small tomato, is easy to grow in the Calichim Smart Pots, the smaller size herbs. I have a whole indoor garden seed collection, which I think around 10 varieties, including some microgreens. So get those started, and that way in 6 or 8 or 10 weeks, you're gonna be harvesting. 6 or 8 or 10 weeks takes us to what? November? That's crazy. Into December? That's kind of nuts to think about Christmas coming up. But if you start now, you're gonna be really happy, because that way at that time, you're gonna have some indoor veggies ready to harvest. So it's definitely something I'm gonna be starting to plan and think about this week, and hopefully you guys will too. So let's see, let's jump back into the chat. I think that's all I had to mention. Grab that indoor garden seed collection. I also have some little small 1 gallon size smart pots. These are the 5 gallon behind me. The 1 gallons are really nice because they do fit on like a little shelf. If you have like a window that you can put them in, they're really nice for indoor growing. And I really specifically designed that whole collection based around those of you in mind that can't grow outside in the winter. So definitely check that out. That's a great resource for everyone. Okay, here's a question here from, or a comment. Oh, I guess a question from Tina. In zone 5 in New York. Thanks a lot, Tina, for your question. First time growing hot peppers. Terrible growing season. Finally, they have tons of fruit. That's exciting. Flowers, highs in the 60s and lows in the upper 30s and 40s are ready. Should I cover or pick everything? That's a great question, Tina. Peppers have this amazing ability to overwinter, more so in mild winter climates, but can also be done in colder climates if possible. If you're getting into the freezing temperatures, which it doesn't sound like you're quite already, but if you are getting there, keep an eye on your temperatures. If you're gonna get down below freezing, I would go ahead and pick your peppers. That way you can eat them, you know, while they're fresh, or you can pop them in a plastic bag, stick them in your freezer, whatever works out best for you. You can make something with it like pepper jelly or some kind of sauce out of them if you want to. And then what I would do once you start getting frost and your peppers are kind of done is prune them. And I've got videos on how to overwinter peppers. You can prune them. You can also dig them up, put them in containers to overwinter, like in your garage or up against a sheltered location. And then you prune them. I don't have a pepper real close here, but you can see on this eggplant, you can prune it down to like where there's a Y in the plant. And then mulch them heavily in your garden bed or put them in a container and then bring them back out come warm weather, and a lot of times they'll start growing back. They just have this amazing ability to overwinter. So give that a go. If it's really light frost or maybe in the 30s and 40s, you may want to try covering them at night just to protect them a little bit, to keep your harvest on the plants just a little bit longer. Okay, Edward says he's been getting lots of snap peas and apples, great garden snacks. It's really fun, Edward, to snack on those right in the garden, and really, really fun to do that. Very, very rewarding. Okay, Hindi360 has a question. How can I have success with root vegetables such as carrots, beets, parsnips, please? Any tips on fertilizing? Appreciate your help, Kim. Okay, those love the cool weather. So I say that's probably the biggest tip is once your weather gets cool enough, I'm not sure where you live, but they like temperatures under 75 degrees, they'll take some frost because they're under the ground. So a lot of times if you get them established before the frost hits or really hard frost hits, they'll do pretty well over the winter time, especially if you mulch them heavily. The biggest problem I have with them, and I don't know if this is your issue, is the heat. We get those random warm days, and when that's the case, they just grow a lot of leaves and don't bulb up too fast. So plant them in full sun in cool temperatures. You really don't need to fertilize them too much. I usually just make sure I mend the soil real well at planting time. Don't fertilize them at all because then the leaves grow and not the root vegetables themselves. So hopefully that will help. Okay, I think we have time. I think I've run through all of what I'm doing in the garden this week. It's more than enough to fill my time this week, but I am definitely going to be working on it a little bit each and every day. So I'll come back next week and let you guys know how it went. And I want to hear what else you're doing in your garden this week. And let's see, V says, are you planning any recipes from Garden Goodies? V, I don't know yet. I may kind of mention some in videos, but honestly, recipe videos are not my favorite to film. They're very time consuming because it's getting all the ingredients out, setting it up. It's very, very time consuming to film recipe videos. So they're not my favorite. But usually what I try and do is kind of give some ideas like on my Instagram or in some of my videos of quick ideas. I'm not a huge cook. I really do a lot of the same type of stuff. I kind of get boring when it comes to the kitchen. We grill a ton. I roast a ton of vegetables. And I try and mention what I do in my videos or in my Instagram posts. So hopefully that will be helpful for you. At this point in time, I don't have a lot of recipe videos planned. Renee says, do overwinter potted plants need to be watered? Great question. I actually get that question a lot. What I would do is keep them just moist. You really don't want them to completely dry out because then the roots might die, but keep them just moist enough to keep them alive, but not like super, super dripping wet. Okay, let's see here. Any other questions before we sign off? Terry says, I need to mulch. Can I use charcoal pebbles? I have some from another project. I live in zone 10. I have never used charcoal pebbles. I really don't know anything about that. If anyone else has any experience with that, if you could help Terry out, that would be awesome. Precious is planting my fall garden. You and me both. Exactly right up there with you. And Melissa says, Callie Kim, I finally have Wonder Peppers. That's awesome. Those are the best peppers. I think I have a couple behind me here that need to be picked this week. This eggplant definitely needs to be picked. And I might even have another Black Beauty coming on. You guys might have seen that from the garden tour last weekend. And it's still in my freezer, my refrigerator, actually. I think we're going to cook it tonight, maybe on the grill. Okay, guys, it has been awesome being back. Really fun. Make sure you join us again next Monday, noon Pacific time. I'm in the chat at 9:45. So it's really fun to hang out with you guys pre-live stream and chat, see how you're doing, get to know you a little bit better. We always have a great time. The moderators are in the chat at 30 before noon at 11:30. So make sure that you come back next week and join us and share with your friends too. We would love to keep this gardening community growing. All throughout winter, because I know sometimes winter gets a little bit like, oh, it's winter, it's dark out, a little bit on the downside. So let's keep our spirits up during the winter time, share with your friends and help spread the gardening love. All right, guys, have a great week. We will see you on next week's live and a video in between. And don't forget the 20% off with code HAPPYFALL. Take advantage of that. The last day is today. All right. Love you guys. Great to be back. Bye-bye.